Hello, my name is Fritz de Mul, and I would like to introduce you to the electric field of a polarized object. This presentation is part of a series of presentations about topics of electromagnetism. Suppose we have a polarizable object, dielectric object, and an external electric field, EX. The question is, calculate the electric field produced by, so not in, the polarized object. We first have to perform the analysis of symmetries and so on, find an approach to the solution, do the calculations, and draw some conclusions. The analysis. Assume the z-axis is parallel to the external field. And the result of the polarization will be that the dipoles inside the dielectric will be aligned along the external field. Suppose we have n dipoles per cubic meter, and each dipole carries a dipole moment p in Coulomb times meters. The dipoles will be directed along the electric field, so that means that the vector p is parallel to Ex, and n and p will be homogeneous. Approach to the solution. The question is, calculate the electric field in an arbitrary point outside V. The approach. First we calculate the potential, and from the potential by differentiation of taking the gradient, we calculate the E. We have distributed dipoles, that means that we have to perform an integration over the volume elements dV filled with dipole moments, a dipole moment element dP. We take a volume element dV, and that volume element consists of a dipole moment element dP, and the dipole moment element can be written as n, the number of dipoles per cubic meter, times the dipole moment, times the volume of the element dV. And dV can be written as dS perpendicular, and perpendicular means perpendicular to the z-axis, times dz. The dipole potential is given by the scalar vector product of the dipole moment times the ER unit vector in the direction of P, divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R squared, and R is the distance between the dipole moment volume and P. And so dV can be written as dP times the cosine of theta divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R squared, and cos and theta is the angle between the dipole moment axis and the direction to P. And so the potential element can be written as NP times dS perpendicular times dz cosine theta over 4 pi epsilon naught R squared. Here is that expression again. Now let's take the cross section through P and the z prime axis. Here is the z prime axis through the line of dipoles here. This is a cross section, the cross section through P and the z prime axis. We have a top and a bottom, and lines to P here, RT and RB. The same figure again, and the expression for the potential element. Now we perform the z integration, and do that in the form of integration over R. And that can be done in this way. dz can be written in dr using the angle here. dr is dz times cosine theta. And so dz is dr divided by cosine theta. And thus, we can write the potential element in the form of n times p times ds perpendicular times dr divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r squared, because the two cosines cancel. Here we have that expression again with the integration element dr. And now we have to integrate over first over r and then over all the volumes. So all the columns here, all the ds. Now let's introduce the polarization. Capital P vector is n times the dipole moment. The P then is in 1 divided by cubic meters times coulomb times meters is coulombs times square meters. So P is such as a charge density, a surface charge density. And then we can write the V as the integral over the surface times P divided by 4 pi epsilon naught times 1 over R top minus 1 over R bottom. Here is that expression again. PDS perpendicular can be written as the vector P with scalar product with the vector DS, and DS is the normal on that surface. So now we introduce bound surface charges. DQ is PDS. And now we can write the V in this form with the dq divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. Conclusions. We have bound surface charges. dqb is pds. V can be written in this form. Integral over the surface dqb. And the conclusion is the field of a polarized volume is equivalent to the field of bound surface charges, provided homogeneous polarization, and the polarization is defined as the bound surface charge density in coulomb per square meters. Thank you very much.